Okay, now we're going to cover the most basic trig identities. We'll cover the more complicated ones in a separate video. We've already seen a couple of them, that the sine and the cosine of a complementary angle are the cosine and the sine of the original angle. Two more have to do with what is the sine and the cosine of minus an angle. If you've got your unit circle and here's your angle theta, minus theta is going in the opposite direction. You can see the height flip sign. These have the same x-coordinate. Well, they would if I knew how to draw properly. They have the same x-coordinate, so they have the same cosine, but their y-coordinates are negatives of each other, so you get minus the sine. The sine of 30 degrees is 1/2. The sine of minus 30 degrees is minus 1/2. Okay. You put these two things together, and you get what happens when you add 90 degrees to an angle. So if you want the sine of pi over 2 plus theta, the sine of pi over 2 plus theta can be written as the sine of pi over 2 minus minus theta. And that's the cosine of minus theta, but that's the cosine of theta. And likewise, the cosine of pi over 2 plus theta is minus sine of theta. Same kind of argument. And last, we've got the identities. These are sometimes called the Pythagorean identities. If you know the sine, you can figure out the cosine because sine squared plus cosine squared is 1. If you know the tangent, you can figure out the secant or vice versa. If you know the cotangent, you can figure out the cosecant or vice versa. And the thing about these identities is they all refer to very specific triangles. So remember SOHCAHTOA, that we've got that if we've got an angle theta, and we're going to assume for now that it's between 0 and 90 degrees, that the sine was this, the opposite over the hypotenuse, cosine was adjacent over hypotenuse, tangent was opposite over adjacent. So what happens if the hypotenuse is 1? The sine is this side divided by 1, so this side must be sine theta. The cosine is this side divided by 1, so this side must be cosine theta. So the Pythagorean theorem says sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. And whenever you're thinking about sines and cosines, it's useful to write down this triangle. Another triangle has to do with what happens if this side is 1. Well, we know that the tangent is opposite over adjacent, so this is the tangent of theta. And the secant is the hypotenuse over the adjacent. It's 1 over the cosine, so this side is secant theta. So, Pythagorean theorem, this squared plus this squared equals this squared. Tangent squared theta plus 1 equals secant squared theta. You can also get this by taking this equation and dividing by cosine squared theta. Sine squared divided by cosine squared is tangent squared. Cosine squared divided by cosine squared is 1. 1 divided by cosine squared is secant squared. And the last one is what happens if this side is 1? Then this winds up being the cotangent of theta, and this winds up being the cosecant of theta. So you get 1 plus the cotangent squared of theta equals the cosecant squared of theta, which you could also get by taking this equation and dividing everything by sine squared. Sine squared divided by sine squared is 1. Cosine squared divided by sine squared is cotangent squared. 1 over sine squared is cosecant squared. So those are the basic trig identities. We'll get to the fancy ones next time.